Good morning, guys. This is my next project. This is the motor of my Weber rotisserie. Here is the other part. So this end of the shaft fits in there, and it turns around to cook your whatever meat you've got on your rotisserie. So I'm going to open it up and clean it, give it some grease or oil. It is in working order. There's no batteries currently in, but I used it a long time ago, so it's time to open it up and see what's going inside, and just to give it a little bit of maintenance. Okay, I've loosened all the screws. There's only four, so let's take it quickly out and see what jumped out here. Hopefully not a lot of gears. Then I have to struggle again to get everything back together. Okay, let's take this battery section away. And now we can try and open it. Okay, this side is only a plate. And here is all the motors and gears and stuff. So it looks if it will be a fairly easy job to check out. So let me give it a eyeball here. Okay, I want to give you some shots of the gears. And it looks if it run dry, gentlemen. I can't see any excess oil or grease inside. Let's look from another angle. Okay, this is from another angle. There might be a little bit of oil, but definitely not a lot. So maybe I can put a little bit of silicon grease on, just a little bit, but all the gears look in a very good condition. So this is really a quality machine, and I used it a lot. I'll show you now why I say that. So if we look at this part, this is the section that go through the meat and go through the ring. I'll show you the ring now. And this turn in the hole of the ring, but it is bended over, so it's not a sharp edge that turn there. It is a rounded plate, can you say? And you can see there is some marks. So actually it doesn't look too bad, but I used it a few times. Okay guys, you see that black ring there around that gas barbecue? This is the extender that you put on the Weber in order to put your rotisserie in action. I've got here a little tube with silicone grease that came a long way with me. We used it many years for very delicate parts to grease. So I'm going to use some of this. To oil or to grease some of that parts. Okay, here's an idea of the silicon grease that I put on all gears. I think we can put it together now and clean it on the outside. Okay, and after cleaning, it looks brand new again. But what is interesting, this is very good quality, that is for sure. But what is interesting is I see here, now it's upside down. Made in Taiwan. But the Weber product is definitely USA. So I believe of either this battery part that you can open. This part is open, is made in Taiwan, and this in the USA, or under license, everything from Taiwan, but definitely very good quality. Okay, so I think we can, if I can find a two batteries, we can give it a test run. Okay, gents, I cannot find batteries now for it, but it is in a working condition. And in the next video, I need to make a new one of these. I lost one. So maybe not the next video, but in upcoming videos, I need to make another one like this for the other side. Okay, guys, and now for a good friend of mine, that Mr. Dan O'Connor. I just want to show, Dan, this is the part on your bulldozer that you need. This action. So what this do is, on your bulldozer, it is on the floor where the gears normally is. If you will pull that, if you can manage to make something, what happened, you can see there, that action there, and this part fell off, so I need to secure it back. It need to sit there, other way around. It need to sit there, and then you can see there, it will click over that shaft, and that hold the bucket up. And when you pull on this lever, it will release and it drop. So this is the action that I want to show you that you need to make on your bulldozer. You've got everything here in place, but there is a problem. So, but it sit there inside, so you have to open it and make something that gives you this action. So I hope this helps. Yeah, this is my Massey Ferguson 165 Corgi out of the 70s, I would say. Very nice little model. Okay, gentlemen, this is all for today on this video, and thanks for watching. And do all that other nice things that you know, if you would like to see more. And I will see you on the next one. Bye-bye.